to ensure that there are no Trump surrogates appearing in the future. The only way to ensure that there is no widening echo for right-wing demagoguery is to build the left and to build progressive movements. And that is why, my fellow activists, my organization, Socialist Alternative, and I are proud to stand with Jill Stein for president. Jill Stein and her fellow activists weren't on the board of Walmart, haven't gone around the world promoting fracking. They have been activists on the ground, and Jill was the only presidential candidate and perhaps the only political candidate running for office that went to Standing Rock to stand with the activists. And there will be a lot of people asking you, asking me the question, what is the point of voting when we know she's not going to win? Our approach, I believe, should be a welcoming approach, because I can guarantee you, and I know you know this too, a lot of people who are voting for Clinton are not excited about her. This has been an unpopularity race. Trump is the least popular candidate, presidential candidate, in 10 presidential election cycles. The only way he was not completely pushed aside because he happens to have the luck of running against the second least popular candidate in the last 10 presidential election cycles. And so, my fellow activists, let's welcome these debates and conversations where people are not going to agree with us right now, but convince every person that is ready to be convinced that their vote for Jill Stein counts. It counts very much, because if we are seriously fighting for social justice, to defeat climate change, to actually have a society that benefits not just a sliver at the top, but provides decent living standards and ends racism and misogyny for all of us, then we have to have a much longer vision. We cannot allow ourselves to be sort of pigeonholed into one presidential election year. We have to convey our message of strength, our positive message, that this is about building a long-term strategy for social change. That strategy requires fighting both the Democrats and Republicans. That requires building mass movements. And many will ask you, isn't it easier to push for change within the Democratic Party than try to build one of our own? No, let's be sober. These many activists cannot build mass movements. For mass movements, you need masses. So our job is to reach out to those people who are as disgusted as we are at the status quo, but are grappling for where to go. And so we should explain that in reality, if we hamstring ourselves to this presidential election year versus the other presidential election year and so on, then we buy into the logic of lesser evilism ad nauseum. We have to break from it. And there will never be a good time to break from it if you buy into this idea that the best choice that American working people, those people who go to work every day and make our cities run, those who have built every city brick by brick, that the only thing they can hope for is not having a sexual monster in office, and that they have to accept the Wall Street agenda. No, everything around us tells us, as Teresa was saying, the tide is turning. There are so many millions looking for a way forward, and that way forward has to imply building mass movements that are independent of parties dominated by corporate interests. And that is why building mass movements requires for us to also build a united independent party of the 99%. I'm so happy that Jill and I and our organizations and many activists have joined together in this call to build a united independent party for the 99%, because that is the only way forward. And so every vote for Jill Stein this year helps us raise the morale and the confidence of working people who are constantly told by the ruling elite that this can't be done. Let's fight until November 8th to get every vote for Jill Stein and Jammu Baraka, so that we are as well set up as possible to begin talking to many, many working people, young people around us, that this can be done, but it will require grassroots efforts. It will require us to come together and fight corporate politics, you know, in a united front, and really push against the domination of Wall Street, against the domination of the oil lobby. Can we do this?